Hello guys, how are we doing today? Welcome back to our channel and welcome to this video. I want to believe you're doing good, I want to believe you're doing great. In this video, we're going to be doing an analysis of GBP/JPY and what to expect from the market this week. In case you're just coming across our videos, in case you're just coming across our channel, I want to say welcome, it's good to have you. What you want to do right now is click on the subscribe button and turn on the notification bell, because we release videos like this almost every day, letting our viewers know what to expect from the market per time, and you don't want to miss out on any of such videos. Before we get into the business of this video, let's speak a bit about what happened in the market last week. When we did our last analysis of GBP/JPY, the market was here. You can see the market ended as a bearish engulfing bar, which gave us reasons to say that the market will sell. And looking at the weekly time frame, it ended as a shooting star. You can see that here. So this gave us reasons to expect the market to sell. Then on Monday, the market ended as a doji. Then on Tuesday, there was news on GBP. I think that was the Fed's rate, funds rate, and Bank of England governor was giving speech. So there were a couple of high impact news. I think three, if I'm not mistaken, three high impact news on Tuesday on GBP, which caused the market to buy quite significantly. So on Tuesday, the news altered the direction of the market as we were expecting, and you can see after then the market bought. So let's start our analysis on the monthly time frame. On the monthly time frame, you can see GBP/JPY bought quite significantly from here up to this region, and at this region we started seeing bearish contention or bearish intention. The market sold down here, but again the next month the market ended as a bullish candle. The next month ended as a bearish candle. Then last month the market sold down here, and towards the end of the month, which was on Tuesday, we had a strong bullish rejection and the market bought up to this region, then ended as a pin bar. Then this is the month of November. We can see how the market is currently looking. Now let's consider the weekly time frame. On the weekly time frame, we can see the market bought up to this region, started selling, bought again and sold again. Then at this region, we've had contention among buyers and sellers. We could see the market, the candlesticks around this region were more of dojis and with long wicks. So at several points we've had bulls running the market, all of a sudden bears coming in and pushing it. So it's until last week we're having the market close for the first time as a bullish candle and closing above the 10-day simple moving average. This is after about is it 5 or 6 weeks, as we can see here. So this is the first time it's closing as a bullish candle and closing above the 10-day simple moving average. Then let's consider the daily time frame. On the daily time frame, like we've said, the markets sold from here down to this region. Then we saw it started buying and it ranged around here for several weeks. Then last week on Tuesday, we had this huge bullish move. Then the market sold a bit, and on Friday, it ended as a bullish candle. Then the 4 hours time frame. On the 4 hours time frame, we've seen the movement of the market. So after it bought from here on Tuesday, got to this region, sold a bit, and bought again on Friday. So that's what happened in the market last week. What do we expect from the market this week? Firstly, let's get back to the monthly time frame. On the monthly time frame, we can see it's pretty clear from here that the market has bought for several years. I think since 2019, we can see GBP/JPY has been buying. Then looking at the RSI, we can see it has gotten to the overbought region. And looking at this region, we can also see that it is currently at the resistance region. are we together? So last month ended as a pinball, which shows strong bullish pressure. A pinball is actually a bullish reversal candlestick pattern, and it's occurring on a resistance region is proposing a buy, but at this region, some people also call this a supply region. So at this region, what is more expected is a sell, especially for the fact that the RSI has gotten to the overbought region. That's fact number one. Then coming to the daily time frame, we can see that the market started selling from here, ranged here for a couple of weeks, then started buying. Bought up to this region, sold a bit, and bought again. So at this point, the market has made a morning star, which is a bullish reversal candlestick pattern, and it proposes that the market will buy. Then the weekly time frame, like we said before, that this is the first time the market is ending as a bullish candle and closing above the 10-day simple moving average in the last 6 weeks. Yeah, in the last 6 weeks. So from this region, JPP, JPY started making signs to sell. But right now, it is making signs to buy. Now, this is what I think, or this is how I think the market will play out. At the moment, in the imminent, there are bulls in the market. There's more bullish pressure than bearish pressure in the market right now. Even though on the monthly time frame, we can see that it is currently at the resistance region, it is overbought. All of those facts are real. But at the moment, there is more bullish pressure than bearish pressure. There's more chances that the market will buy than it will sell. So for that reason, we will expect the market to buy for a while until we see signs that it will sell. You understand me? So the monthly time frame has gotten to the resistance region. The RSI is at the overbought region. So that is supposed to propose a sell. But at the moment, what the lesser time frame is showing us is that it is buying. So for that reason, that's what we will play with. That's what we will roll with. So there is currently bullish pressure in the market, and we expect the market to buy this week. Looking at the weekly time frame, I believe it will exceed this region, which was the previous high. So I believe it will exceed that region. There's also a possibility that when the market opens, it will sell a bit. You can see the 4 hours time frame ended as a bearish Arami. So there's possibility that it will sell a bit. Maybe perhaps till it comes in contact with the 10-day simple moving average. It may not also get in contact with the 10-day simple moving average going to make a bullish reversal candlestick pattern. But what we are saying is that at the open of the week, at the beginning of the week, it's likely to sell a bit. Afterwards, it will buy, and we expect the market to buy quite significantly. Let me see how far it will go for those who will be able to hold that much. So the red horizontal line, that's CP1, and like we said, at the open it's likely to sell a bit before it finally buys. So that's what we're expecting. That's how far we expect it to go, 185.8, and there's also a possibility that it will exceed that and perhaps gets this high. Let me mark that also. So TP1 is 185.8, TP2 is 188.5. So that's what we're expecting from the market this week. If you have a different opinion, you can use the comment section. If you have any question, you can also use the comment section. I'll be glad to have a conversation with you. Like we always say, trading is a highly risky endeavor. You don't want to venture into trading without proper knowledge. If you know you don't have sufficient knowledge about trading, you don't want to take this trade, you can watch this video for educational purpose, and it's going to serve you better than risking your hard-earned money in something you don't fully understand. If you want to get a Forex course which covers beginners to advanced lessons, it has 30 videos and 3 ebooks, including my book Trading Without Tears. Check the description of this video. You're going to see a link where you can get the Forex course. I strongly recommend this course for anybody who's just starting out in the Forex market or someone who is yet to find his way around the financial market. We also have an option where you can get the same course at 70% discount, but for only 1 month. So if you can't afford to get access to the course for lifetime, you should be able to afford to get access to the course at 70% discount. And within that period, you should be able to watch all the videos and read all the books. Then you reserve the right to either cancel your access or renew it. So if you want to get access to the course at 70% discount, check the description of this video. You're going to see a link where you can do that. If you want to subscribe for our Signal service, we'll give proper entry, stop loss, and take profit. Check the description of this video. You're going to see a link where you can subscribe for our Signal service. And if you want to get a copy of my book, Trading Without Tears, check the description of this video. You're going to see a link where you can get the soft copy. If you want the hard copy, send us a direct message to any of our social media handles. You can find our social media handles in the description of this video. Tell us your location. We'll tell you the cost of shipping it. Once your payment is confirmed, you have the book delivered to you. So that's it from us on this video. I hope you got value. See you in the next video. Bye for now.